The Blank Park Zoo, the Des Moines Botanical Center, for sale? It could be the answer to Des Moines' city budget problems. Welcome back, everyone. Todd Magel is here now to explain this possible move. And are they serious about this, Todd?
They actually are serious, Kevin. You know, when you've got an $11 million hole in your budget, you need to do whatever you can to get very serious about finding money wherever you can get that money. So city-owned properties like the zoo are getting a closer look.
The Blank Park Zoo is one of the city's oldest and most recognized institutions, but it costs taxpayers hundreds of thousands of dollars a year. And it's much the same for the Des Moines Botanical Center, which needs millions of dollars in improvements. So now the city is thinking out loud. Would a sale of assets like these help balance the budget?
Cash is hard to come by.
City Councilman Chris Coleman says he likes the idea and says many cities are doing it.
We're making some tough decisions here, and it would be nice to have every luxury. And let's face it, we've had a lot of them as a city, but now it's time to make those tough decisions because we can't afford everything.
The city has already sold the old downtown library to the World Food Prize. City Manager Rick Clark says that's the kind of money-saving ideas that make sense and save property owners from higher taxes.
We are putting together a budget that will accomplish a balanced budget without increasing taxes. That's important to us.
But selling the zoo or the botanical center are just ideas at this point.
We like all the ideas, so if you've got a great idea, we want to hear about it.
Now, the zoo is actually operated by the Blank Park Zoo Foundation. CEO Mark Vukovic says that he is willing to work with the city on any kind of a money-saving idea.
And the Waterworks actually operates the Botanical Center now, right?
That's right. They have for a while. And actually, a private group is interested in buying the Botanical Center now. So that could solve that problem fairly quickly. So stay tuned for that.
Stay tuned indeed. Thank you very much, Todd. Also, the former home of Top Value Foods on the city's north side would also help raise a little money for the city. City Manager Rick Clark telling us today that several buyers are interested in the defunct grocery store at 8th and University. He wants to get $2.5 million property back on the tax rolls and pay off federal loans on the building. It's been empty now for about 5 years.